Hello everyone, welcome to Elephant Insurance Management. This is Desi here with you. In previous classes, we were discussing about what are medical coding and how can we become a good medical coder, and then what are the guidelines for ICD or what are ICD-10 codes and all. In today's class, we'll be discussing what are CPT codes. CPT codes is otherwise known as current procedural terminology. So from the word procedural itself, we can understand that this is something related to the procedures. CPT codes are an integral part of the medical coding system or medical coding sets of the codes. And this particular code helps or tells the payer or the insurance payer that what procedure or what test is being done for a particular patient in a healthcare facility. CPT codes describes the tests, the procedures, the evaluation and the management, the radiology, pathology, laboratory, medicine, all those things done for a patient in a healthcare setting. Whether it's an outpatient, inpatient, home care, whatever it is, irrespective of the type of the facility, whatever procedures are done for a patient, we will code this particular CPT codes to tell the payer what procedure is being or what tests are being done for the patient. When we come to CPT, it's being designed and maintained by the American Medical Association as usual. And then this CPT codes are categorized or divided into three particular categories. That is the category 1, category 2, and category 3. In the ICD-10 codes, these were divided into two indexes, that is the alphabetical index and the tabular index. And for the ICD codes, it had one alphabet in the beginning and then the numbers. Whereas when we come to the category 1, 2 and 3 codes, mainly we have numbers and some codes are having alphabets. But so we'll move on to each categories. First one is category 1. Category 1 CPT codes are the main CPT codes which are used by a medical coder most of its time for coding all the procedures. 99% of the procedures, tests, radiology, laboratory, whatever it is, it's coming in category 1 codes. Or all the procedures are coming in category 1 codes. These codes are 5-digit numeric codes which does not contain an alphabet, and these particular codes are assigned in various orders. According to the type of the procedures or the situations, it's being divided into 6 different sessions. That the first one is the evaluation and management, that is regarding the consultation, whatever is done for a patient in a physician's office, whether it's a new patient, established patient, whatever it is. Second one is the anesthesia. That is when a patient goes for a procedure. Before the procedure, the anesthesia will be given to the patient. So the vital status of the patient, how the anesthesia is being administered and how much time it was taken, and what are the types of the anesthesia administered to the patient. This is given in the section 2, that is the anesthesia. Third one, or the biggest or the worst session of the category 1 codes, are surgery. Surgery codes helps us to understand what are the procedures done for a particular patient according to each system. Surgery session is again divided into different sessions according to the system of the body, like for example the integumentary system, the respiratory system, etc. And this surgery session has most of the codes. Then moving on to the fourth one, that is the radiology. Radiology procedures or the radiology services like X-ray and all comes in the radiology session. Then the next section will be the pathology in the laboratory, where we have all the laboratory examinations or investigations done for the patient, the codes for that. And the last one, or the sixth one, is the medicinal code. The type of the medications and the route of medications, why we are administering the medication, this comes in the sixth session. So category 1 code is being divided into six sections, and then we have to take the appropriate code from each section when we are doing a procedure, and then we have to allocate those codes when we are sending the claims to the insurance payer. Whenever we are going to code a particular procedure, we should be thorough about what are the procedures done for the particular patient, and then like what are the things that were used during the surgery or the procedure. Everything should be noted, and then the codes should be assigned properly. Moving on to the second category, that is the category 2 codes. Category 2 codes are not permanent codes assigned on behalf of category 1 codes or a replacement for category 1 codes. These are just codes to provide additional information to category 1 codes. Like for example, like the heart failure assessed or the blood pressure monitored, these statuses or the assessments or additional informations for category 1 codes are being given by the category 2 codes. This category 2 codes will help us in reporting the status of the patient, and when the patient will come for the next visit to the clinic or the hospital, we will be knowing what is the health status when it was assessed in the previous session. Then moving on to the third category, the category 3 codes. Category 3 codes are new experimental or emergent technology codes which are not permanent. These codes are present in the category 3, and then once an unlisted procedure is there in category 1, we have to go and see whether it's listed in category 3, and this, if it is listed, we can use that particular listed code while we are coding a particular procedure. These category 3 codes are temporary codes which will be archived in the category 3, and then later on it will be shifted. If once it is like made permanent, it will be shifted to the category 1 codes, or it will stay in the category 3 once it's already unlisted in category 1 codes. These are the three sessions of the CPT codes, and then according to the procedure done for our patient or according to the types of the anesthesia or whatever it is being done for the particular member, we have to assign the proper code or the proper procedure, and then this will help us to get a proper payment once we are going to submit to the insurance company. This is all about the ICD-10 CM and the guidelines for the CPTs. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any queries, you can put in the comment box that we will be answering those. And if you have not subscribed us, please do subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get more notification about the videos that we are posting. Thank you for watching once again. Thank you.